And there is one of those pucks right there. And they didn't want you to sign, Ron. And listen, ladies and gentlemen, I have to say something. If you're still watching this game, you are the biggest hockey fans in the world. If that isn't one of the worst periods I have ever seen, two professional teams put on, absolutely stealing their money. Now, Ron, are you there? Are you going to ask me a question or what? You're in it. Where are you? Oh, by the way, you see this? Let's quiet for a minute. You see this? This is St. Valentine's Day because next week some kids are going to make us a suit or something we have to wear. So happy St. Valentine's Day. Okay, go ahead, Ron.
I'm here in St. John's, Newfoundland. Yes. The viewer may have noticed because of hometown hockey tomorrow, Don. And guess what I had for lunch today?
I know. I heard of eating a seal, a little baby seal. What do you eat seal? Come on. What are you, savage,
that would upset
a barbarian?
You.
Anyhow, I want to talk
Mallard's
about
Cottage. I had a seal burger, and the only challenge for Todd Perrin, the chef, was it was hard to know when to flip her. Anyway, tell me about the Leafs. What's the problem?
Imagine meeting a seal. What kind of barbarian? Anyhow, minor midget game last night, and everywhere I go, I'm never going to kick anybody when they're down. I'm not. I've never said anything about the Leafs, but everywhere I go, out in the storm at 11:30 last night, what's with the Leafs? Now, let's just go along. Let's go back 2 years, all right? Everybody was terrified of the Leafs. I know for a fact they did not want to play the Leafs because if you come in, you might have beat them, but you were going to pay the price. And you're going to say, oh, well, yeah, fighting. Led the league in fights, made the playoffs, except for 12 minutes they could have went on. They were a tough team. Kessel grew a foot. Condry drew a foot. They all they had a swagger about them. Look at them now. And those two guys are down. There they are right there. They beat us, and we beat them in Ottawa that game. We were flying high at the time. Oh, no, those guys are in the minors now. All I have to say is, and Clarkson's out now. I don't understand that one. He isn't the worst player. They have no identity now. Nobody, their own coach said they play soft. The worst thing you can say about a hockey player, they're soft and heartless. I'm not saying they don't have heart, but they should be ashamed to put a period on like that. Off like that. Get the two guys up here. At least get them played and get a little respect, get some swagger. Don't go and play a period like that. All right, what's next?
Mark Fraser, too, playing so good with the New Jersey Devils. Your Islanders' fourth line, you've said that's been a secret of their success.
Listen, let me tell you something about their fourth line. Watch this here. Mark, now listen, he got into a fight last night with Ryan White, Brandon Boy. He breaks his nose pretty good. Watch this here. As Brian Williams said one time, you get hurt in a fight. Yeah, that's the idea. Don't worry, Martin came back again. He's going like, don't worry about that. The fourth line shows that's the bad news right there with the fourth line. But let's see the good news when it comes up. Watch this here coming up here. Watch Clutterbuck gets the winning goal. You gotta have some respect. Both teams, listen, Tavares and guys like that, they have a swagger, that team there, because they're a tough team, and that's what the Leafs got to do. Love that fourth line. Sedaitis on there, too, anyhow. Go ahead.
That's our Brian Williams, so that was true. Brandon Prust.
Oh, you liked him, Brian? He's with another thing. Brandon Prust. Now, here's another guy. Watch Kaleida or whatever his name is. Hang on to it. And the referee sucked it in. Got it like that. He held on to him, and he hands his stick back. The referee got sucked in. But watch Prust. He comes out, knocks Tyler Myles down, and watch what he does. This is the kind of guy you got to have on your team. A heart and soul guy like Prust knocks him down. You got to do this. You got to hit. I'll tell you, I'd hate to see somebody picking the three stars tonight in that other game. That's the way to do it. Do it good, right?
You'll inspire Jordan Eberle to give you a better second period.
All right. Here's Eberle right now. Hold it. I've always said when you're going down the side, I've remembered this 100 times, don't put it in the bread box. Put it along the ice, and you'll pick up the red. Watch this here. Schultz put it along the ice. Watch Eberle. Nice. Zings her home. Here it is again, shot along the ice, just like I said, puts it in. That's the way to play hockey. Don't put it in the red box. They look pretty good, but they don't look good tonight.
You got a choice. We can do the Alain Vigneault, or we got to get to Evander Kane.
I'm going to do both. Put Vigneault on. Go ahead and put it on, what that guy said. And what he said was, and go ahead and play it right now. Go ahead.
A couple days ago, Alain Vigneault quoted the great hockey thespian Don Cherry when he was talking about easy early, that first pass out of the zone, make the easy pass and do it quickly. He just yelled to his players, move the puck. You got to move the puck quicker. I think that's been a little bit of his exasperation in this early going.
Well, what happened was Vigneault watching Coach's Corner. Everybody watches Coach's Corner. He said that I told Bobby Orr, early, easy, and that's what his defense do, and that's why they're winning. I didn't tell Bobby Orr. Bobby Orr told me all defensemen should early, easy. If Bobby Orr can do it, anybody can do. Now, Evander Kane, you know, of all the guys, I have been in your corner since the beginning. When you had the pile of dough, I said, he's just a kid. I showed you walking in how great you were walking in. Now what you do, the shift there like 2 weeks ago, how great you are. What you did with come in to a team meeting, everybody's got a shirts and ties on, and you come in a tracksuit, you should be ashamed of yourself. You're in a fork road right now. You are a jerk right now, and don't think you can fool me with the operation. Their operation is they didn't want you around. And what you put that team through, watch Wheeler right here. This is what they think of you right now.
There's a standard that everyone needs to live up to. We're professionals. We make a lot of money, and we're expected to uphold a certain standard, and that's the code we live by. And that's just the way it is. You know, if you don't like it, then there's other places to go. This is the way we do things.
And you know what? They're hanging by a thread, and you disrupt the team right now. You're at a fork in the road, like I said. You can either be a jerk. You're going to got 4 months to listen and think about it. Either be a jerk or be a good hockey player. If not, as like Wheeler says, get out of the game. Smarten up and
Don
don't Cherry, be a jerk.
The coach's corner, Don. Good stuff on Hockey Night in Canada on Rogers.